In this video, I'm going to review Flippa.com and show you how to use it. I'm George Morse from e-commerce brokers, and we've been helping people build, buy, and sell online businesses now for over a decade. We've sold millions of dollars worth of businesses, and specifically, we've sold $250,000 worth of businesses just on Flippa. I'm going to walk you through the three steps to buying and selling on Flippa, and then at the end of the video, I'm going to give my own personal review of the platform. So let's get right into it. So firstly, what is Flippa? So Flippa is an online business marketplace where you can buy and sell online businesses. They've been around for 13 years and they've reportedly done over $140 million worth of sales. In my experience, Flippa is a great platform to buy and sell businesses, especially under $250,000. They've been in the game longer than any other marketplace, which means they have more data and they've progressed in their vetting more than anyone else. Now, there are other marketplaces, but they haven't been around as long, which means they don't have as much data to work from like Flippa does, and they haven't progressed as far on the vetting front. So they don't vet their buyers and sellers as much, which is a priority when you're buying and selling a business. Now, the first thing you're gonna wanna do is set up an account. Now, I'm gonna walk through everything on screen. Now, over the years, Flippa's really progressed with how they vet buyers and sellers. And as you can see from the setup process, they do ask for quite a bit of information, which is a good thing. Now, depending on how much information you actually provide them, they're gonna give you different levels of confidential information. In other words, the more details you provide them, the more you're gonna be able to see. So, you're a buyer. How do you buy on Flippa? Now, the first step is filtering and due diligence. So, as a first-time buyer, you wanna have a good idea of the type of business you wanna buy and how much you actually wanna spend. But you might also be flexible on both of these fronts. So, if you are pretty open to just seeing what is out there, you can just scroll down the listings page and basically go in reverse chronological order, so seeing the most recent businesses listed, and see if there's anything that sparks your interest. I would say that the best place to start is knowing the type of business you want to buy and how much you really want to spend. For example, you might have a budget of a maximum of $50,000, meaning you could probably afford something in the 100K range. Take into consideration, you might have an earnout structure, seller financing, or an SBA loan. Now, if you don't know what those are, their financing methods, I have other videos about them coming out, so feel free to subscribe to watch them too. So now that you have a budget, you want to choose the type of business you want to buy and base this decision really on what you're most comfortable with, where you might have experience, and whatever you're most familiar with. Because at the end of the day, you're going to actually have to operate this business, or at least manage the business, especially if it's your first acquisition. You want to play with something you actually know. I'm going to choose revenue generating because I want to buy a business that's actually making money, and all the other categories that come under this are fine. Dropshipping, physical products, etc. Now, when I'm looking to buy on Flippa, I always go from the most expensive to the least expensive and basically start scrolling from there. The thing you want to do is start looking for indicators of a good business. Now, as you scroll down the page, you'll start seeing a few things that might spark your interest. For me, the first thing I always look for is net profit. If it's not making a profit, it's almost definitely not something I'm going to be personally interested in, and most buyers are interested in. The next thing is site age. Myself and my buyers don't really buy anything under a year old. My sweet spot is 2 to 3 years old, so that the brand at least has some brand recognition, some brand equity, and has gone through the growing pains of starting any business. Then I look at multiples. The profit multiple really shouldn't be over 5x, especially when you're looking to buy a business that's valued under $1 million. If it's over 5x, the seller likely is inexperienced or is going to be too difficult to negotiate down to a reasonable price. Now, the revenue multiple isn't important because that's more used for startups, so you can not worry about that. So based on this process, I choose a few businesses, I open them up in a few different tabs, and I'll start digging into the information provided. And basically, I'll see if there's anything that's a good fit for me. If I like the business, then I contact the seller. So, step two, communication and negotiation. So you found a business, or at least a few businesses, that are within your price range, they're in a specific category or niche that you're comfortable with, whether it's e-commerce D2C, Amazon FBA, content sites, KDP, SaaS, or apps. And after reviewing them, you can take the next step. Now you need to communicate with the seller and basically start negotiations. There are a lot of different negotiation methods, and you can go your own way. There's a lot of books out there, and I actually have a list of negotiation books that I recommend, which are on our site, ecommerce-brokers.com. Link is in the description. And they give you a good idea of how to start. To keep it simple, I would start with some questions around the specifics of the business. So, how do they drive traffic? How do their logistics work? Do they want to sell? How quickly do they really want to sell? Why do they want to sell? Then you can progress to more the due diligence stage where you're asking for Google Analytics and some other back-end access. So Shopify back-end if it's a Shopify business. So now you've got a bit of an understanding, you've had some back and forth with the seller, and it's time to start your due diligence. Now this is its own world, and again, of course, I'm gonna do a video on due diligence, how you should do it, best providers, how to do it on your own, how to do it with third parties. But after you've done some high-level due diligence, you can really start getting into the nitty-gritty of negotiating. So, first you want to ask them how they actually came to the valuation. And unless it's really based on data and a few third parties that brokers or listing sites that give a good indication based on data, most sellers are usually pretty happy to negotiate on that. So, the first thing I would do is see if they would accept 30 to even 40% less. This will give you a good idea of how much they're willing to actually move on price without insulting them too much, right? Following up, I would ask them if they're willing to accept a bit less for a fast transaction. It's a good way to knock 20% off the price. Step three, closing and legal. So you found your agreed upon price and structure, and you've had a few calls back and forth over maybe a few weeks or even a few days, and you want to move forward. The next step is to sign a letter of intent or an LOI. And basically this confirms your intention to buy the business and conduct due diligence, at least over a 30 to 45 day period, which is a pretty normal period of time, especially for a business under $1 million. Now these letters of intent also give you the exclusivity to buy the business during the period. The due diligence starts after the LOI. Those 30 to 45 day periods is when you're diving into due diligence. This is a whole world of its own, like I mentioned. But during that exclusivity period, you really want to get started on your sales agreement. The asset purchase agreement, where you're actually putting the legal document together for close, which will happen at the end of the exclusivity period. Now, after that due diligence period, you sign the agreement and you pay, at least the upfront portion if you're doing an earnout or a self-financing deal. You can pay via platforms like escrow.com, or if you have a broker like us, we actually have a escrow service. Escrow.com is pretty good. We've used it a bunch of times for hundreds of thousands, millions, I think, dollars worth of transactions. It's safe for both parties, and it all happens on basically 2 to 3 days. The funds of the buyer go into an account, the escrow account, the sales agreement is signed, and the assets are transferred, then the funds are released when the seller and the buyer approve. It's like a nuclear warhead. You gotta both approve. It can't be one-sided, it's gotta be both of you. Weird example. Now, at the end of this process, once you've paid as a buyer, or you know, you've sold as a seller, that's where Flippa gets their percentage. And I think it's about 5% last I checked, without a broker, a Flippa broker. How do you sell on Flippa? Now, step one to selling on Flippa is listing and due diligence / documentation. So the selling process is a bit different, as you can imagine. The first step is to list your business. And it's a pretty smooth process. I've done it a ton of times. Maybe a few years back, it wasn't so smooth. You had to like manually put the numbers in. Now it's pretty smooth. You can just upload a P&L. They have a lot more people working on Flippa now, so they kind of just do it for you, which is really great. But the more information you provide, the better. Buyers like to see more information about something they're potentially going to buy. So provide as much information as you can. It's going to be behind a confidential, an NDA. So really you can provide as much info as you want and it's safe. Now, as you're listing the business, like I said, it's very intuitive. You can link your Google Analytics, your Shopify backend, and a bunch of other platforms like Stripe and so on, which is a pretty new thing that's come to Flippa, which is great. I mean, you can't make up those numbers. It's fact. And it incentivizes a buyer to buy a business because they know it's Stripe. They're not, you know, fudging the numbers there. So you filled out the information. Now you can go to actually listing the business. Each tier means how much visibility it's really going to get. And they have paid options. The more you pay, the more visibility you're gonna get. It's pretty much simple. You can, of course, also use a Flippa broker or a broker outside of Flippa. Now, Flippa has a list of brokers that they've partnered with. That doesn't mean they work for Flippa, they don't work for Flippa. And we actually, that's how we've sold $250,000 worth of businesses on Flippa. We partnered with them, well, we basically have listed our businesses on Flippa. A few of them, and sold them on Flippa. And it's a pretty good process. Sometimes they'll send sellers to brokers, and it's a pretty smooth process, helping them list, helping them sell. So, step two to selling on Flippa, communication and negotiation. So you've listed your site, you've chosen a tier of visibility, and you're getting views on your listing. Buyers are commenting, they're contacting you, what do you do next? You want to communicate and provide as much information as possible. Answer buyers' questions, do everything you can to be clear and transparent. I would push for a call, a video call, so they can see your face, they can see you're a real person. Now, your valuation should be pretty reasonable and realistic. If you're looking to get a fair and reasonable valuation, Flippa actually has a valuation tool at the end of the listing process. So you can use that. I would also get a third party's opinion, whether that's a broker like us, someone who sold a business in the past, or just look at some reports. You know, brokerages like e-commerce brokers gives out reports almost every quarter as to what are the multiples looking like for certain businesses. If your valuation is based on data and given by a reputable company like e-commerce brokers, Flippa or another broker, and your business is at least a year old and it is stable and or growing, you have a pretty good shot to basically get the valuation that these people have provided. And you shouldn't move too much. Maybe 15 to 20% if to get a quick deal done and so on, but you shouldn't really move from that valuation too much. In terms of seller financing and earnouts, they're there for the buyer. They're there to mitigate risk. So they're less preferred by sellers. However, they are usually the structure that gets deals across the line. So step three, closing and legal. So you've agreed upon a price and structure. Now you want to get your attorney or lawyer to review the letter of intent, which is the basis of your sales or purchase agreement, and basically get started on drafting the agreement, usually done by the buyer, but seller can also do it. Or at least doing annotations to the buyer's sales agreement. During the due diligence process, you will be providing all the information that you have on your business, including financial history, even tax returns, which is why it's important to have an NDA. After due diligence, it's time to sign the sales agreement and receive payment. Like I said, this is where you as the seller pay the 5% commission to Flippa. Or a broker, it's usually a bit more, maybe 10%, I think. If this process sounds a bit too convoluted, it's your first time, that's what a broker is for. That's what a broker like e-commerce brokers like myself is there for. And we charge a few more percentage points more than Flippa. We charge 10%, but we take care of the whole process. And we have 10 years of experience in getting deals done. And we have a huge list of buyers. Okay, George, so what's your personal review of Flippa? I've used the platform now for over 3 years. I've done $250,000 of sales on Flippa. Like I said, they've really improved over the years. Their vetting has gone really, really good. I think it does a really great job of what it sets out to do. So I'm giving it an 8 out of 10. If you like this video and want to see more videos about building, buying, and selling online businesses, be sure to like the video below and subscribe for more videos just like this. Visit ecommerce-brokers.com if you're looking for someone to help you buy or sell a business. The link is in the description below. Now I have a question for you. Have you used flippa.com in the past, and what was your experience like? Let me know in the comment section below.